The Lynette Brown Show. This be the Lynette Brown Show.
She's always ready and no time.
The Lynette Brown Show.
When you got something that's on your mind.
The Lynette Brown Show.
Whatever you got going on, she knows the deal.
The Lynette Brown Show.
Where we always keep it real.
The hottest, the biggest, the baddest talk show in the South. I am the Fiery Diva, keeping the airwaves hot on your favorite station. Thank you guys for tuning in with me once again. Got a nice show lined up for you, ladies and gentlemen. This show is titled Letting Go. Oh, goodness. So what inspired the Diva to do a show of this magnitude? Because I was watching a nationally syndicated talk show, and it was about a mom on there, and she had boys that were really grown, and she didn't want to let them go, okay? And I mean, they were a lot older than my boys. So, you know, you can always spot the fly on somebody else's nose, but you can't see the one on your own. So I'm sitting here doing, you know, like we're going to talk to Bruce a little bit, and he's going to talk to us a little bit about some of the mistakes that we as women make. But we'll be back right after these messages. Don't go anywhere. I'm coming right back.
32 years, Jimmy Smith Jewelers in Decatur has offered fine and distinctive jewelry to the Tennessee Valley. Jimmy Smith has a unique selection of fine jewelry in all categories. Full appraisal services are available, and they're members of the American Gem Society Laboratory. Diamonds. Jimmy Smith Jewelers knows diamonds. With diamonds imported directly from Cutters in Antwerp, Belgium. Jimmy Smith Jewelers. Brilliant quality, brilliant selection, and brilliant service. Southland Plaza,
welcome
Decatur.
Back to the LBS, the hottest, the biggest, the baddest talk show of the South. I am the Fiery Diva, keeping the airwaves hot on your favorite station. Thank you guys for tuning in with me. We've got Bruce Jones here today, and the title of this show is Letting Go, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, you know, I was inspired to do a show like this because I was watching a nationally syndicated program where a lady was a very overbearing mother. And Bruce, welcome to the show, and thank you so much for coming. I'm telling Bruce to tune in, but thank you for coming.
Sure.
Now, Bruce, what are some of the mistakes that you see women like myself that are single mothers and we're raising children? And I know you and I, we've had dialogues before.
Yeah.
And thank God for Bruce, because he has given me so many tips far as how to, you know, work with my boys. What are some of the mistakes you see that's being made?
Well, first of all, let me just say that, you know, instead of saying the mistakes that women make because single women make, because a lot of times, you know, single moms are left with that task by themselves. So, you know, it's not something that they ask for. Sometimes the fathers have bailed out or divorced or whatever the case. So a lot of times when they divorce the mother, they divorce the kids. Or sometimes there's no marriage. It's just a relationship. And when that ends, they think that everything ends there too. So, you know, I want to give props to the moms who do stay and fight for their kids and try to do the best they can for their kids. So props goes to that. But, you know, in doing that, though, you keep in mind, you know, it took two people to create that child, a man and a woman. And so that child benefits from both. You know, it benefits from the mom, whether it's a male or a female, it benefits from the dad. So when the dad is absent, then that child is going to miss something because they're going to gain something from that male. So the mom is left there to try to pick it up or to give it to them or, you know, whatever the case might be. And there's just no way possible because she wasn't created for that.
That is so true. Right. And that's what I'm dealing with, Bruce.
Right. But what you can do, though, is just, you know, there's a lot of books that you can read about it. The Bible is one good place you can find a lot of wisdom on raising our kids regardless. And I seek the Bible for a lot of my wisdom as well. But there's a lot of books, a lot of, you know, you need the Bible. And ask other guys. Ask other respectable guys who are raising kids or who are good fathers. You know, how do you handle this or whatever? And they can tell you some, give you some tips that can help you too. But I guess when you ask the question, what are some of the common mistakes that moms make when they're raising their boys? One is that he's not your man. He's your son.
That's right.
And I'm not talking about in a perverted way.
I know.
That's not the case. But a lot of times, women are nurturers.
Yes.
Women want to, they're built to take care of the home and the man, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
And even though, you know, we're in new times, new era, I still think that holds true for most women. So in doing so, when the man or the husband or whomever is not there, then the likely person for them to become that nurturer, that person to take care of, is that child.
That's right.
So in doing so, you start to treat the child as though he's, you know, the man.
He's the man of the house.
Yeah, and you, they sometimes don't give them responsibilities, don't give them chores. They even allow them to communicate with them on a level of an adult instead of, you know, that child where, you know, if they get an attitude or they say certain things, you know, you cut that off right there. You don't
right.
allow that, you know, to happen, because if you allow it to happen, then to that boy, especially in that home with that female, they become to think that, you know, I'm on the level of a mom or I'm on the level of a man. So, you know, how are you going to bring that down now
right.
at that point?
Right, because once you've started it,
yes.
it's hard to end it. And Bruce, let me say this. This is something that I've seen. I've seen children curse.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just having a conversation and they're cursing in front of their mother.
Mm-hmm.
You know, let alone cursing her out, maybe. Mm-hmm. But I'm just saying, cursing in front of their mother. And, I mean, Bruce,
right.
really?
Well, that's my
point.
Oh, my
goodness.
Yeah, that's my point. They become, that male child becomes like the man. And and he acts and does things, or he's allowed to act and do things that man could do and could get away with if he
right.
was in that home. And I think that's a big mistake.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, sometimes these boys start to grow and sprout. They become to look down on that mom. You know,
mm-hmm.
they're bigger, stronger, whatever. So if that mom is intimidated by that child, then out of fear, she would allow some things to go that wouldn't normally go if that man was in the home, because that man typically, that child's going to be a little bit afraid. Now,
mm-hmm.
I take my 13-year-old. I catch him, and he and his mom and I share custody with him. I see him trying to talk to her in a way where
mm-hmm.
he don't even try.
Like
with
that's
me.
His sister.
Yes, or, you know, wants to raise his voice sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And then he almost did it with me one time,
mm-hmm.
and I jumped on it so quick. I said, boy, who do you think you are?
Oh.
Who are you to, I mean, and then he caught himself because he realized,
mm-hmm.
oh, it's that. Then I said, now, and you don't do that to your mom. If I catch you doing it to her, then I'm going to have a problem with you too. But see, I'm around
mm-hmm.
to catch that
mm-hmm.
and to discipline him and to let him know that's not acceptable. When that man is not around at any time, or some other man that is respected, because when I say respected, you can't just show up and be a man and try to tell a kid, you know, this and that, and they're going to respond. You know,
right.
you've got to have put some time, you've got to prove yourself,
that's
and then
right.
that kid will respond, and you know, they'll respect what you're having to say. But if you're just showing up because you mom's boyfriend or you somebody that they don't see on a regular basis and you ain't really pointing to their life,
right.
well, then they're going to take offense sometime to you trying to give them advice, unfortunately. But, you know, bottom line is those kids get bigger, they start to look down on these moms, and there's some intimidation factors about some of these moms. So they tend to let them get away with stuff sometimes out of fear, you know. So now, kid has no fear in the home, and if there's no fear in the home, a lot of times there's no fear in the streets.
Anywhere.
Anywhere.
For those who have just tuned in, you're tuning into the LBS, the hottest, the biggest, the baddest talk show of the South. And we are talking with Bruce Jones, and he is the director of Youth Services in Decatur, Alabama. And we're talking about letting go and some of the things that women do, and we're really not cognizant that we're doing as far as our children is concerned. And Bruce, I'm going to go into a break, and then I want to go back to something we started on
okay.
in the beginning of the show. We're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll be back right after this. Don't go anywhere. The hottest, the biggest, the baddest talk show of the South. I am the Fiery Diva, keeping the airways hot on your favorite station. Ladies and gentlemen, Bruce and I, we had a nice dialogue during break, and I said, Bruce, stop. Don't say another word. We have got to get this on TV. And Bruce, let's go back. You know, I was talking to you about my son. Mm-hmm. You know, he's the only one I have in school right now. And the principal stopped me. It's been a few weeks ago. His phone got taken up. Mm-hmm. Okay, and he's going to get me. Mom, you're always telling our business on TV. Yes. But his phone got taken up, so and it's been taken up multiple times, so I had to pick it up. And the principal, he said, Miss Brown, he said, one thing I've got to say about you. He said, when such and such, when I'm going to call him Baby Boy, when Baby Boy gets in trouble, he said, the worst thing that he never wants to hear, I'm going to call your mama. Uh-huh. Yeah. He never wants to hear, I'm going to call your mama. Right. Bruce, can you tell me what's going on there?
Well, you've established some fear over him. And I don't know why people think that's a bad thing, that to have for your kids to be fearful of you. And I call it a reverence fear, a healthy fear. It's like our relationship with God. We have a reverence fear, a healthy fear of God, because of not that he's going to strike us down because we're bad, but the consequences of our behavior mm-hmm. causes us to want to do right and not make those mistakes and not do the same thing. Because we do know there could be consequences, and oftentimes there are consequences when we disobey God. Mm-hmm. So we do have a reverence, healthy fear of him. I don't know why we don't think we're supposed to have that same relationship with our children.
Yes.
And my son, now I don't know what he does outside of me, but he has a healthy reverence fear of me, because there are consequences for certain things that he does. And that's a good thing, because I'm hoping when he's not with me, the thought of what dad might do mm-hmm. if he find out or if I whatever might cause him to make better choices and decisions. But if there's no fear, there's no worry or concern about what might happen, then a kid is left to do whatever they want, because they know, well, there ain't no consequences, no big deal.
What is she going to do?
What is she going to do? Or she really, you know, and sometimes, well, she don't really care anyway. Because that is showing caring. When you show discipline, when you show love, when you show a structure and you and consequences, that's an act of love, okay? Yes. Because I love my son. I don't want anything bad to happen to him.
Exactly.
So I better set these boundaries and put these structures in place so that he don't get all out there. So that's a sign of love. And kids, you know, you hear people say it all the time. Well, you know, kids, they think that, you know, that you show them love when you do those type things. And you do. That is a sign of love. So I think your son is just reacting out of fear, because he knows what the consequences of what you might do. I'll tell you this, without saying it on air, you probably have to inflict some consequences.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, I'll put it, you know, I'll put it out there, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, let's keep it real. No holds barred here. Bruce, I will shut you down.
Yeah.
I will shut you down. Right. I mean, I will send you to school, you know, with black buddies, high tops. That is the most unattractive mm-hmm. shoe mm-hmm. that you can buy.
Gotcha.
Okay? Right. No name or anything. No minutes for your cell phone. Right. I mean, I will you can't drive a vehicle of mine
right.
if you're getting into it. Oh, right. yeah. I'll shut it down. I mean, right. Now, you know, my daughter, she was teasing. She said, Mom, we don't play with you like that, Mom, because we know you're crazy, Mom.
Hey, whatever it takes for them to respect your rules and respect the rules in society, so that they don't end up, you know,
exactly.
getting into a lot of trouble and having you go through a lot of stuff as well as them. So, you know, moms, you know, because you're talking about the name of it is letting go. So we do need to talk just a little bit about why it's hard for these women to let these mm-hmm. boys go. And once again, it goes to me back to the relationship sometimes with the father or lack of or another man. It's hard sometimes for women to let go of relationship,
That's
even
right.
when they're bad or whatever the case might be sometimes. So it's almost that same type principle, you know,
okay.
not the perverted type, but just that same type thing of, you know, having to the abandonment, you know, not having that child in your life anymore. You're afraid you're not going to have your life.
And they can be the worst child.
Yeah, yeah.
They can be the worst child, but they will not let go.
They hold on.
What is behind out?
And sometimes it's out of fear of what's going to happen to them out there. You know, I don't want anything bad to happen. I know if they're out there, there's something bad happening while they're here too. So, you know, and so to me, I think, and I like to use this parable when it comes to talking about letting go of our kids and what have you. You know, and I like to think about it this way. You know, the prodigal son, and everybody used that. Everybody know about that.
You know about the prodigal son.
Where the father allowed the son to go, mm-hmm. and he gave him his possessions mm-hmm. to say go and whatever, because and of course the kid went out and just squandered it and lived all kind of crazy way, and then he came back home. One of the things I think happened in that a lot of people don't talk about when they use that is that why did the father let him go? Now he didn't have to.
No, he didn't.
Okay. I think that father knew that if I force this child to stay here against his will, or if I allow him to stay here knowing that he's ready to sprout his wing, he's going to create havoc for my family.
Right.
He's going to mess things up for my other children. He's going to have me stressed out. He's going to buck me, and he's going to just become this kid, and I don't want that.
Right.
So I have to release him and trust God, because I have God in him.
That's right.
That he will go out there and realize that it ain't what he think it is, mm-hmm. and then he'll come back more humble mm-hmm. and ready to submit to my authority. And I think we have to do that sometimes as parents. As hard as we think it is going to be, or how bad we think it's going to be for that child when they get out there, sometimes God has his hand on them, and he knows what needs to happen in order for them to get right. So I just think that father in that parable, in the parable of the prodigal son, he knew what was going on. Go ahead.
Bruce, you know, and not to cut you off, I think a mistake that a lot of women make is when they say, well, you're the man of the house.
Oh, Lord.
Those boys will tell you, they have never heard me reference them as being the man of that house.
Wow.
Because, no, I think that's a mistake that women make. No, stop telling those boys they are the man of the house. Because when and if you do get a man, mm-hmm. you're not going to be able to do anything with him. Because that boy is not going to let that man come in, not peacefully.
Okay, so mom done already gave me that birthright.
Right.
Mom
done already made me that. Yeah, I think that's a mistake also.
Well, I totally agree. Matter of fact, I had to laugh when you said that, because I really... I see it sometime on TV, but I didn't know women actually said that.
Yes.
To say that to your male child, who's not working, more likely, not paying any bills, not contributing in any way financially or whatever,
right.
half the time don't even wash dishes, help clean the house.
Exactly.
So what qualifies him for that male role? You know. So I just think that sometimes, you know, it might sound good,
yeah.
and people might think it's cute, or they might even be trying to give their children some props.
Okay.
But you got to be careful how you do that, because when you put certain labels on a child, that label's going to stick, whether mm-hmm. good or bad.
Right.
And you got to deal with the consequences of that label sometime.
You know what, Bruce? I've got to take a quick commercial break. Ladies and gentlemen, for those who just tuned in, we're talking with Bruce Jones, and we're talking about letting go, ladies. Letting go of these boys. And Bruce is the director of youth services here in Decatur, Alabama. We'll be back right after this.
Hey, time. Folks, welcome to Eddie Pruitt Ford right here in Hartsville, Alabama, where we've got a great sale going on that you don't want to miss. Every new car and truck, every used car and truck drastically reduced, including this state-of-the-art new 13 model Fusion, totally redesigned, cheapest price you can find anywhere in Alabama, $21,975, and that's loaded, not stripped, sport wheels, all power equipment. If you want a great buy, new, used, program cars, whatever your need, Eddie Pruitt Ford right here.
And welcome back to the LBS, the hottest, the biggest, the baddest talk show of the South. I am the Fiery Diva, keeping the airwaves hot on your favorite station. Thank you guys for tuning in with me once again, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you guys enjoyed that dialogue with Bruce Jones, okay? Because I was inspired to do that show because I saw this nationally syndicated show, okay? And it was about a mother, and I mean, she was very, very overbearing when it came to her boys, and I mean basically she didn't have a man, what it sounds like to me. Okay, yeah, I've been accused of the same thing, but her boys was a little bit older than my boys were, and these guys couldn't have girlfriends. I mean, they were non-productive. I mean, they couldn't have a functional relationship with a female. As soon as they got involved with the female, that mother would sabotage it. And I mean, she was willing to say that she would sabotage it. She would do whatever it took. And she did not want them to leave home. I mean, this was horrible. This was awfully dysfunctional. So I said, well, you know what? I got to get on the show and I got to talk about it. I got to get on here and talk with Bruce about women and the mistakes we make and learning to let go. And that's been a difficult one for me, because I mean, my boys, I mean, they're big, you know, when you see them. I mean, they're taller than I am, but I'm running around here talking about their little boys, my little boy, my babies. I got to go home and check on my babies and so forth. And when the people see the babies, they're like, babies. So anyway, enough about that, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. But I'm going to go into a quick commercial break, and then I'm going to have to come back and close it out, okay? Thank you guys for tuning in to the LBS, the hottest, the biggest, the bad talk show in the South.
It was brought to you in part by Good Tax Services. Give them a call at 256-353-0379. Again, that number is 256-353-0379, or stop by 1201 Danville Road, Decatur, Alabama. Let a good man do your taxes.
Welcome back to the LBS. It's time to close this thing out, ladies and gentlemen. I thank you guys for tuning in with me once again, okay? But you know what time it is. Get your cell phones ready, okay? It's D-Ball Wanted, okay? And this portion of the show is brought to you in part by Jimmy Smith Jewelers in Decatur, Alabama, ladies and gentlemen, and also Good Tax Services, okay? Got something interesting I want to give away today. Okay, this is compliments of Jimmy Smith, but guess what? This is what I want you to do. You know, we talked about the heartbreak stories, Heartbreak Hotel and everything, and how difficult it is to deal with a heartbreak. It really is, okay? But on the flip side, all the people out there that's brokenhearted, believe me, they did you a favor. They did you a favor because that just opens the door, leaves the door open for somebody else to come in that God's got better for you. Which leads me to this. If you are in love, text me right now, 256-566-5854, all right? If you'll text me right now, 256-566-5854. I know I said I wasn't going to call it out, but I'll call it out anyway, all right? Because if you're in love, then doggone it, I'm happy for you. Okay, guess what I'm going to give you? This is a Camilla adjustable sterling silver necklace, okay? With your choice of a bead, it's $35, and the chain is $30, a total of $65. Compliments of Jimmy Smith Jewelers, okay? And want to say hello to everybody out in Lewisburg, Tennessee. That is where Mr. Smith is from, okay? So I just thought I'd give that little plug right there, ladies and gentlemen. But, you know, Jimmy Smith Jewelers, he's been behind the Diva a very long time, okay? Ever since the Divas just startup days 13 years ago. I mean, a long time. He's been very supportive. So that's what I'm going to give you. If you can text me right now and tell me, you know, if you're in love, tell me who you're in love with, okay? And how long you've been in love, okay? Let me go ahead and move on, ladies and gentlemen. But yeah, that's what you're going to get, okay? This is a Camilla adjustable sterling silver necklace, okay? With the bead of your choice, $35 value, and a chain for $30, $65 value. Okay, alrighty, and Camilla, your life, your style. I mean, this is some beautiful stuff. I don't know if you can see it or not, but beautiful stuff. You need to go and check out Jimmy Smith Jewelers. He is in Decatur at Southland Plaza. Okay, let me go ahead and move on. Okay, Michael Jackson and Paul McCartney had two songs together. Can you text me the name of those songs? Yep, if you can text me the name of those songs, somebody is going to Gibson's Barbecue, okay? If you can text me those songs, okay? Somebody's going to Gibson's Barbecue. Okay, yeah, we got to move right along, okay? Can someone text me right now and tell me who Lenny and Squiggy was? Yep, you're going to get a free breakfast at Gibson's Barbecue also, okay? Yeah, that's a breakfast at Gibson's Barbecue, okay? If you can tell me who Lenny and Squiggy was, okay? Alrighty then, I got another question. Okay, guess what? No, don't guess, because you better know it. Okay, the rapper Tupac Shakur, he was with this particular group before he went solo. Okay, who was this guy, Tupac Shakur? Who was he with? Okay, and if you can text that to me right now, let's see, what do I have here? I think I will give away, what about a Wenzel's Oyster House? Mm-hmm. What about that, huh? Wenzel's Oyster House. All right. Let's just do that, okay? And if you can tell me who Tupac you know, what group Tupac was with before he was solo, before he went solo, somebody's going to win this. Okay, if you can answer that right now. And I'm going to have to move very, very fast right now, ladies and gentlemen. Who was Richie Rich? If you can tell me who Richie Rich was, then you can go to Popeyes. Yep, Popeyes. I want to say hello to Jeff at Popeyes. Thank you so much for all your support of the LBS, okay? Now, moving right on. Okay, who was the gambler? Yeah, who was the gambler? Can somebody tell me who the gambler was? If you can tell me who the gambler was, well, guess what? I think I'm going to let somebody go to Gibson's. Yeah, somebody's going to go to Gibson's. I'm telling you, Gibson's took care of us. they really took care of us, okay? If you can tell me who the gambler was, okay? And I don't have any acting skills right now. I don't have any acting skills today. As much as I would love to do it, I don't have it because I have so much I've got to give away. And I am running out of time, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate yours. You've got to tune in next week, okay? Because I have even more to give away. Goodness. Okay, you know something? I'm gonna do this. If you have I can't let go of the heartbreak though. I still wanna give something to the brokenhearted, okay? Because I feel like you can use this, okay? So if you are dealing with a heartbreak of some sort, I want you guys to text me right now, 256-566-5854. I know I said I wasn't gonna give it up, but you know, it's just a habit. I just keep doing it. But yeah, somebody would like to have a massage. Yeah, what about 1 hour? Yep, healthy living alternatives. What about that, okay? What about that? Yeah, somebody's gonna get 1 hour. And let me tell you something before I close it out. The first massage I got, okay, I remember the lady told me, she says, would you like 30 minutes or an hour? And I said, well, I just want 30 minutes. I'm busy. I've got to do this. She said, well, ma'am, that's gonna go by really, really fast. And I said, well, that's okay. I mean, you know, this is my first time. You know, I'll be okay. Honey, I got on that table. Okay, and she said, Miss Brown, 30 minutes is about up. Are you still ready to? And I said, no, ma'am. I said, keep it moving. Okay, as good as I was feeling on that table. Okay. But anyway, yeah, if you are dealing with a heartbreak, yeah, you're going to get a massage. Mm-hmm. Yep, we're going to give you a massage. Okay. And, you know something, I've got something else too I want to do. This is just something, spare the moment I want to do to you guys, okay? You know, a teacher, coach, oh, whomever. You know what? I'm going to give them a massage. I'm going to give them a massage. 1 hour. 1 hour massage. That is two of them, okay? And this is for a teacher or a coach that is deserving of it. If you'll just text me right now and tell me why. Tell me why they are deserving of this massage, okay? And before I let you go, I've got to close it out. I know I've said that 1,000 times, okay? Under pressure. Got to get out of here, though. But just wanted to give you guys another opportunity because I ran out of time last time, like I'm doing right now. I want you to text me right now. Our number is on the screen, okay? Text me or leave me a message, okay? Email me, whatever. But I have got to give this, no, I don't either. No, I don't have to give it away this week. Gotcha. No, I don't have to give it away. I'm going to give you a reason to tune in next week, okay? But I'll be back next week, same place, same time. Thank you guys for tuning in to the LBS, the hottest, the biggest, the baddest talk show in the South. I am the Fiery Diva. Keep it up, and you're okay. Life can be